This video is brought to you by Storyblocks. Hey folks, Jordi here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to another episode of Creative Tuesday. Now, if you follow us on Instagram, you saw that we were filming for an awesome video yesterday in a parking lot. But after we were almost finished, the security guard popped up and we had to delete everything from our carts. So that video is gonna be for next week. We are trying to recover the files, or maybe we are going to have to reshoot everything again. But it's okay, because I have an awesome Premiere Pro video for you instead, a wonderful editing program packed with tons of features, but some of those features might be hidden a little bit. So that's why we're having a look at 5 hidden features that might make your life a whole lot easier. Starting off with the first one, which can be found under the menu, Edit Preferences, General. This option right here is called Enable Display Color Management. Your monitor has a specific color profile. Most of the time, you can choose this profile from the monitor settings. Now, your timeline could have a different color profile, so what you're seeing in Premiere Pro are not always the correct colors. However, that does not mean that you always need to enable this option. On PremierePro.net, you can find an article that explains this feature in depth, but it also has this table from which you can see if you benefit from this option or not. A lot of Apple users were asking for this function, as the newest iMacs have a P3 monitor, which does not accurately show Rec. 709 footage. I'll leave a link to that article in the description below. Hidden feature number 2, how do you synchronize your audio? Now, you filmed with multiple cameras or used an external audio recorder. Usually you then clap in your hands, and in Premiere Pro you put the 2 claps on top of each other and it synchronizes. But there's an easier way to do that. Simply select the audio tracks which need to be synced. Right-click on those clips and choose Synchronize. From here you select Audio and hit OK. Premiere will do the work for you and synchronize the audio. Now, I've got 3 more tips for you guys, but first I'd like to thank our sponsor, Storyblocks. Now, recently, they've been working on collections in which you can find everything that you need within a specific team. For example, you're looking for drone footage. In this collection, you'll find a bunch of hand-picked stock clips, which you can all download with an active subscription. Another great collection are these elegant After Effects templates, which are amazingly good. And all of this can be downloaded without having to pay anything extra. Now, you can find more information about all of this by clicking the first link in the description below. Hidden feature number 3. When mixing your audio, you could add keyframes on the waveform of a clip to change its volume over time. Now, when having tons of clips in your timeline, it could become a mess when having hundreds of different keyframes in there spanning over different clips. So, from the track options in the timeline, you want to locate the keyframe button. If you can't see it, you might want to expand the track. Click on it, then go to Track Keyframes and choose Volume. You can now create keyframes in there, adjust your volume without having to alter any clips as you're working on the track and not the individual clips. Kind of works the same as adjustment layers for video. This also has the benefit of swapping a clip with a different one or nudging clips around without breaking your audio animation. Moving on to the next one, when you're working on a large project, Premiere Pro could have performance issues, and there's a very quick way that could drastically speed up the project. If you go to the Edit menu, you'll find an option called Consolidate Duplicates, and this will look for video clips that have been imported multiple times and deleted from the project because it has no use. Ending up with duplicates often happens when you're going to combine multiple projects into one, which often happens here at Cinecom. Now, when your editing is done, but you want to keep the project file for later consulting, it might also be a good idea to go back up to the Edit menu and choose Remove Unused. It's gonna delete all the video clips, images, and audio files that have not been used in your edit. And these 2 options are gonna make your project lighter, which in Premiere terms also means less crashes. And that brings us to the final hidden feature, which are VTS plugins. These are audio plugins which can be found all over the web because they are not bound to a specific application. You can find paid ones, but also a ton of free VTS plugins, which can be found on websites such as vtsforfree.com. Unfortunately, things like instruments will not work, but there are many fun effects like Azurite, which I'll leave a link to in the description below as well. Now, when you download one of these VTS plugins, you end up with a DLL file. Store that file anywhere you'd like. Then in Premiere Pro, you click on the menu of the effects window and choose Audio Plugin Manager. From the top, you first add the folder in which you've stored that DLL file, and then you hit Scan for Plugins. If it doesn't appear, it means that the VTS plugin is not supported in Premiere Pro. If it does, it will show itself right here. Then go to your effects library, search for that Azurite effect, and drag it to your clip. In your effects controls panel, scroll down to the audio effects, locate your VTS plugin effect, and click on edit to open up the actual plugin from where you can make any changes.
And this is one of those fun things that the Azurite plugin can do.
If you'd like to see more of these advanced features inside Premiere Pro, then make sure to check out the playlist in the description below, as we've got a whole more hidden features, tips, and tricks all for you. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Guys, if you've ever wondered how we make our Instagram photos, well, it's exactly like you thought. Exactly like those Instagram girls. Look at that. Janik is posing like a model. Look how sexy he is. Damn it, Janik. Wow. You're doing amazing.